Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can create an online character to use as AI influencer, or maybe you want to start a social media channel and you want to post images out there. I will show you two different solutions. The first one will use an online service, Shaker.ai. The website is an online model hub and it offers some high quality models. They also provide some premium models, which I'm going to talk about later. And as you can see from the banner here, it says that it only provides safe for work content. So upfront, as I'm scrolling down, you will not see any not safe for work images here. Now, if it is your first time using the website, at the top, you have a search bar, so you can search for any models out there. There's also a filter here, which you can use this drop-down icon to get more choices. I'm going to go with photography. And then just above the drop-down icon, there's another drop-down filter for the type. I will choose checkpoint. That's going to be the main model. And then you can choose any of the different Stable Diffusion version. I'm going to go with Stable Diffusion 1.5. Now on the left side here, you will see that I'm under the model section, but there's also an AI generator. This is the tool that we are going to use to create that online profile from the website. If you are a model creator, you can go to the top here. There's a create button and you can create and upload your models. Now there's also a membership option, and right now I'm under the free plan. So as you can see in the free plan, you get 200 fast tokens and this will reset every single day. Now I'm not saying that you get 200 image generation, because depending on the model that you will choose. So if we go here, there's Stable Diffusion 1.5, 2.1 and XL. It will cost you different tokens. Now if you already have Comfy UI or Automatic 1111, then you can download the models and use it directly in your local installation. When you go into an individual model, on the right side here, you will see a run model button. There's also a download button if you want to download the model. For now, I'm going to click on the run model option, and this will take me to this AI generator tool. Now, as you can see, I have one picture already generated here. On the left side, you'll get gallery, so you can take inspiration from any of the images that other people generated and shared publicly. On the right side here is where you'll be able to add the prompt. So this is going to be the positive prompt at the top. Then we have a section for negative prompt. By default, it's already populated. And if you click on this button, AI generator, to go to the AI generation image, you will need to choose a model. Because I went into a model and click on the run model, it automatically selected the model for me. Then there's a section to add LoRa. You can add a reference image. That's going to be for image to image. Different parameters for the key sampler. Then the image size at the bottom. So now if you are doing Stable Diffusion 1.5 and you choose image size 512 by 512, you can see that the generation cost is only one token per image. If you go to a portrait image, that as well, it's the same, one token. And if you go 768 by 768, that is when it's going to increase. Now, if you're doing SDXL, that's going to be 1024 by 1024, and that's going to cost you 4 tokens per image. So depending on the model that you're choosing, and then the size of the image that you want to generate, the token cost will increase. For me, I'm going to go with image size 512 by 768. Type in a prompt and then click on the generate button. Now, this canvas that you're seeing here, you can think of it as an image feed. Is basically like a scrolling canvas. So the first generation would be in the top, and then you scroll down, you will get your next generation that you've done. All right, so we got our first image. It's right here. And the next step would be to just generate until you get something that you can use. Now next, let's say you want to correct something from the image. You can use the InPaint option at the top. You can also upscale and you can use the different tools that you have at the top. Yeah. Now, if you want to download this image, you can right click and click on the download option. This will download the image to your downloads folder. If you hover over an image, you will also get the option to create subtle variation. You can change prompt or use it as a reference. All right, so I've changed the prompt for something that I can use and I was able to get an image. So as you can see at the top here, this is the total number of tokens I have remaining for today. And I've just used 3 tokens to get a good image. Now at this point, what I would suggest you to do is to click on this remove background option and it will tell you image background removed successfully. If I right click, click on download. All right, so as you can see here, I have this checker box and it's just telling me that it's transparent. Oh, by the way, removing the background does not cost any tokens, so that's a good thing too. Now next you want to go to the hub once again under models, and this time you will want to think about a background that you want to use. So I'm going to go with the architectural and space design and I'm going to use the interior designs model. Choose any of the starting image, click on that image info icon and then copy the prompt and click on the run model option. Type in your prompt for the interior view that you would like to have. Make sure that you have the base model selected. Everything else should be good. Make sure that the image size matches the first image that you've generated. And then click on generate. Okay, so this is good enough. You can right click, download. Now next I'm going to use Krita as my photo editing tool. You can use Photoshop if you have it. You can use GIMP or any other tools. Even Microsoft Paint will work. I'm going to create a new image, making sure that the width and the height is the exact resolution that I use to generate the images. And simply going to File, Open, and then open the different images that you have. So you should have a background and a foreground. I'm going to rename this one as my background and then get the foreground and rename it. All right, so once you have your background and your foreground imported, if you've done the remove background, your character should be already cut out of that background. So if I move my character, you can see that I can see the background behind. Now next, you just need to composite the image and place your character. You may have to resize the image. Now as you can see, the main character, the foreground character is too sharp. So we'll need to add a blur to the foreground. Now in Krita, to do this, we can press Ctrl and hold and then click on the layer to select it. So make sure you're clicking on the foreground layer. Next, go to select and then shrink selection, and you can shrink the selection maybe by 20 pixels. You'll need to invert the selection, so you can go into select, invert selection. Next, go into filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and then add a little bit of blur and press OK. And now you can see the character is now blending a little bit more. And finally, you will save the image. If we check the membership, we can see that the basic tier will give you access to exclusive models as well as use some of those premium models for commercial purposes. So there are some premium models and you will see this icon, this crown icon that says members only. So in order to use these models, you will require the basic plan. But most of the models is available in the free plan, as you can see. I will have a link in the description below where you can check out the website. All right, so on to the second method. I will be using Comfy UI for that as it's flexible. I'm going to load a very simple basic LCM SD 1.5 text to image workflow. If you'd like to get the same workflow, I will have a link in the description below. Now, same thing, just select your model, type in your prompt, and then generate an image. For the prompt, I'm using the same prompt as before, but I'm using a different model now. Okay, so I have an image, have the character, and I can see that the background is not messy, which means that I should be able to cut out the character. So inside of Comfy UI, to cut out the character, you can use any background removal technique. I'm going to use the Comfy UI Bria AI background removal custom node. You can go into the manager, custom node manager, and search for Bria, and this is the one that I'm using. It will require the image. If it is your first time using this custom node, it will automatically download the model. As you can see, we have the character cut out. Next, we'll need a background. So I'm going to copy the key sampler, VAD code, and then the save image, Control C to copy, and then press Control Shift and V to paste. It will keep the connection. Make sure to change the seed number, use any random number. And in my workflow, because I'm using the basic pipe, I can go from a basic pipe to the from basic pipe. And what we will do is break down this basic pipe into these individual components. This will allow me to change any of these fields here. So for me, I want to change the positive field. So I will add a new clip text encode. This is going to be for the background. I can get the clip from here and then type in a prompt. Right now, I still have interior design, so I will try to use the same checkpoint and see what I get. Now, since I'm modifying the positive prompt, I will need to go back from this node to a basic pipe. By the way, if you're not using the basic pipe, you can use the simple reroute and that also will work. Now I'm going to use my new positive. The negative would be the same, VAE is same, clip is same, and then the model is same. So I'm just adding a new text to it. Okay, make sure that the seed is changed. Click on generate. Okay, so I had changed the prompt. The previous prompt was not working for the character that we have. Now I've got something that I can use, and it's the background. So we have the foreground, we have the background. We need to composite it together. When using the Bria node, if you go from this image directly into an image composite mask node, and well, let's make this the destination. The cutout image is going to be the source. And because it's already cut out, we don't need a mask, but there's a problem with this. Let's do a preview, and it will tell you that the images are not compatible. And that is because we have alpha information in this one, and this one do not have, so it's incompatible. Instead, we'll need to use the original image, which has the background. So we send that as the source, and then we use the mask from the Bria node. So we use this mask over, and then generate. And now you can see that we have the character placed on top of our background. Now, because this is Comfy UI, you can change the control before generation for the seed to random. If you want to keep the same background, you can keep the same background, but I'm going to keep the same character. Instead, I will change the seed for the background, and you can see it going to generate a new background and then composite the character on top of that new background. And this is all happening automatically now. You can have your prompt, change the seed number, and if you put it as random, you will automatically get a new background or new character, and you can keep on generating as many times and then pick the best one. If the background is too close or maybe it's not the right proportion, as you can see from this image, the door is this size. Even though the door is further away, the character is just too tall for this one. So in that case, before you do your composition, so this section here, you will need to get the background into an upscale image. You can upscale the image, whether you use the upscale by model or normal one, but just say we are going to upscale it by 1.5. Now you can see this image is bigger. By the way, if you want higher resolution in your background, you can also do like a second pass. So you can take this image and pass it to another key sampler to do a second pass and then get more detail in your image. Since this is going to be the background, I'm not going to do a second pass. You can do it for your character. If I take my character here and then I place it roughly where it's going to lie, I said this one is too tall because now it feels that the character is shorter. So this is going to be a challenge that unfortunately will happen when you're trying to automate the system. So the previous method of using like an external photo editing tool is that you can control individual images, resize it, you can deform or do any transformation on that particular layer. However, it's a manual process. And this one, while it is automated, it's not guaranteed that you're going to get the correct proportion right off the bat. Now, this method that I've showed you is going to work even if you have a character or a photograph that you've already taken. You just need to use a load image node, and let's make as if this is my background. Because this one is in a landscape mode, I'm going to add an image crop to it. and I need to cut it by 12 by 7/6/8. I'm going to use center and then with an offset. This will change based on the image that you're using. I'm going to use this as my background, so I can send that over as the destination. And now if I Q, you can see I have my character on top of the background. Now, of course, the background is darker and it's also blurred, so the character will need to match the background. Now, there are a lot of tools that can correct colors, do color correction, or any other transformation. You can go into the manager, custom nodes, and the one that I am familiar with is called layer style, but there's also one that's the composition node that is going to give you tools like the color correction, then generators, and so on. There's also these nodes which can give you color correction. So just search in the Comfy UI manager at the top for whatever node that you're looking for, and then just pick one. Click on the name, it will open the GitHub repository, and then you will get description on how to use it. If it is unclear, then just move on to the next option that you have available. Alright, so I think this is where I'm going to stop it. This was the second method I showed you. It gives you more control and you can control individual elements. However, since it's automated, don't expect to get every result sized correctly or will be at the correct proportion. And this option showed you how you can use a photograph or a picture to use as your background, but you can also use another load image node. And this is just a photograph of me. I'm going to pass this photo over to the Bria node and it cut me out. So I can use myself and place me on a different background. So, right. So again, you'll need to go through and make sure that you're resizing, cropping the image correctly in order to place your image. Okay. So that is it. I will have a link in the description below. You can check out the website shaker.ai. And one thing I did not mention is that you can download the models that you found on shaker.ai and then use it in the Comfy UI workflow here. Alright, so once again, I will have this workflow in the description below. You can download it for free. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.